Junk is my business.
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you? Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy. A runaway dad, huh? I've seen plenty of them before, but none with the big 101 on their back. Good luck finding him. Maybe the armored vault suit will help you out there, huh? That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun. Target? Whoa, no, no, no. It's not that sort of job. No, I'm talking about researching things, like surviving in the wastes and such. And I can offer caps and meds and a few of my inventions in return. I guess I can even get you some ammo, if that's more your style. Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a Wasteland Survival Guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words. Good enthusiasm! Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first? Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring me back a mine for my studies? Really? Wow, tell me all about it. Did you get blown up? Oh, of course. Can't let little things like flying shrapnel slow you down, now can you? I know you may not want to see any more explosives for a while, but obviously you know your way around them. Have a couple rainy day toys of mine. I've got to see how safe it is to scavenge food from one of those huge stores out there. I still need to study a living specimen with radiation poisoning. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy? Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it. Oh, great! Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay? Try not to die!
Hi there!
Hell of a day, isn't it?
personality. Robbed.
So, how's the scavving been? Got the food medicine from that super-duper mart? Really? You did? You did! Well, all right! Tell me all about it. Oh, dear. Well, I guess the dangers around those old supplies keeps it from being smooth sailing. Otherwise, they'd have already been looted, huh? Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit. My treat. The taste kind of grates after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better. Yes, that's what I need your help on. I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning so I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that. Oh, but nothing beats a real-world example. And I have a new rad treatment I was just itching to try out on a live subject. But I guess you're right, and at least it keeps you safe and sound for later testing. Here's some spare chems for your help. It most certainly does. And if I keep writing in the style of some of your reports, this is going to be one mighty slick book. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We've still got two more chapters to go. The second chapter is going to be a bit trickier, I think. It'll cover how to handle creatures out there, for better or worse. For example, repelling mole rats, learning about mirelurks, and when all else fails, how to handle being injured. So let's buckle down and get to work on this chapter. What's first? Well, I never get to study anyone who's severely injured, not without them crying to be fixed right away or trying to bleed out and all that. But obviously, you can handle a lot of abuse. So if I'm ever going to find a good example of human anatomy and injury resistance, it'd be you. Next time you get badly injured, return here so I can examine you before I heal you up. I mean, you're going to get yourself hurt anyway, right? That'll save a lot of time and effort. Oh, and blood on your part. A real-world example might help more, but I won't turn down the help. Oh, and here's your pay for it all. Guess you earned it by working smarter, not, more self-destructively. There's a sort of mole rat repellent I've developed. I need it to be tested on a few mole rats before I can say it's a success. There's a lot we don't know about mirelurks and how intelligent and dangerous they are. That definitely deserves research. And that should be it for the second chapter. Which do you want to check out? Mole rats can burrow into almost anything and cause a lot of trouble. So I figured I'd make a chemical repellent stick for people to shoo them off. But I need it to be tested before I put the recipe to paper in the guide. So I need you to find some mole rats and test it out a bit. It'll be easy. One tap with the applicator and it overwhelms their senses with a sort of feel-bad sensation. Then they're gone before you know it. You could test it out on just a few mole ratties, but for real testing, try it on 10 or more. There should be plenty in the tepid sewers downtown. Oh, I can't wait to hear how the repellent's working. Just a few? Well, I'm sure it'll be good enough. So, how did my chemical repellent work? Safe and clean like a charm, I bet. Oh, that isn't what I want at all. People already have all sorts of ways to kill them. We don't need a more lethal mole rat trap, just a better one. I guess it's back to the drawing board for that repellent. I wonder if I can make it into some sort of fuel. Anyway, I'll just take that. Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them. Yes, knowing more about them can help people learn to avoid or even outsmart them. So I picked up this observer device to study them in their natural habitat. I need you to hide one in one of the spawning pods in their lairs. That's great. I recommend the nest at the Anchorage War Memorial. I knew a trader who talked about the mire lurks down there. Just go inside and find one of their spawning pods, probably down near the water. Put this observer inside and get out quietly. And be sure not to kill any mire lurks inside their nest. If you do, it could ruin the validity of the study. So, are they intelligent? Do they have a leader? Some sort of king? Ooh, or priests? Ooh, or some sort of scaly community center?
Did you know the... So...
I'll bet most people would have just gone in there, guns blazing, without half a thought. But not you. You're the best research assistant ever.
I've been getting a good signal, but what do you think about them from your first-hand observations of them?
Well, they certainly aren't making tea and having nice chats, obviously. But maybe you're right. Any social development is minor at best. Some of these observations about their armor and camouflage gave me an idea for reinforced neutral colored headgear. Here, consider it thanks for not interfering with them. Oh, speaking of which, take these, so you can continue to avoid them in the future. Oh, it's very real and very complete.
I think I'm really capturing that sly and stylish way you have of getting around problems out there.
Of course, I worry I'll write with too much style and not enough substance. So keep bringing me back good research, and that won't be a problem. Here's your payment.
I know ammo isn't really your style, but think of it as excellent bartering material.
The last chapter is a bit more esoteric. It's about the survival of humanity as a whole and how to rebuild society.
Deep stuff, huh?
We need to know how large settlements are formed, how to harness the old technology, and I'll need you to get ancient history from a nearby library.
We're in the last stretch now, so let's finish it up strong. What's first?
It does, doesn't it? I mostly just deal with it after it's junked. But a trader gave me this Robco processor widget. He said it's worth a fortune.
According to him, if it's connected to the mainframe in the Robco factory, you could have access to all the robots you'd ever want.
Now that would be a great example of how to harness technology, wouldn't it?
Yeah, you should just be able to plug it into the mainframe at the Robco production facility. It'll give you access to the robots and terminals.
Okay, here. And be sure to keep an eye peeled for any other examples of how to make old technology work for you out there.
want something?
Fiddle with any interesting technology lately? Harnessing the technology of the past and modifying it for your own purposes? That's just the thing! Tell me all about how it worked out. Hey, robots are people too. Well, some of them. Kinda. Well, okay. Not really. Still, just in case you anger a few of our more metallic brethren, have a few of pulse grenades I picked up, just in case. Oh, and take my book on science. For some reason, I just can't get into the computer parts, but I've got the rest pretty much memorized. I want to find out the history of how a successful settlement... Also, there used to be a big... And that'll be... Oh, that sure saved me a lot of time. But I bet their book wouldn't have anything about exploding mole rats, would it? Books are where the old world kept its knowledge, and libraries are where it... See if it's still... Great! The library should be an old... If you can't get those, then even the card catalog would be useful. Oh, come on!
I got my eye on you.
Well, is it there? Are there books? Really? All of it? Not even a single tattered paper bag? Oh, that's terrible. Just like the Library of Alexandria County. What a loss to the world. But... I guess I promised you some pay, didn't I? Yes, Rivet City's in particular. It's the mo- Of course. Oh, now- Try it!
Hell of a day, isn't it?
Any luck finding out how Rivet City got started? It is? I've never heard of anything like that. I don't even know anything in books about that sort of things. Unless... Oh my goodness. Do you think it's originally from Atlantis? Or maybe Mu? Maybe they started the war. I never would have guessed that without you. This could change everything. Here, have your pay. Our book is going to be huge.
smooth, suave, and done with a smile. I swear I picked up a few pointers from your style myself. For all your hard work, I want you to have this mini nuke. I kept meaning to use it to dig a well, but honestly, it just makes me nervous. Now, I just need to do a few last tweaks, and it'll be ready to print and distribute. Thanks for all the help. I know it was a lot to ask, but we made a great piece, and it's bound to help humanity, you know. I'll share these with the traders, and soon everyone will know about the Wasteland Survival Guide. But before that, here's your complimentary copy, complete with my compliments.